Hey, builders, how are you? Are you enjoying reInvent? Where's the coffee? I didn't listen to anything. Today, team, we're going to talk about a topic that I love a lot, that is security and generative AI. Obviously, this is a trendy topic right now. And security is job zero at AWS. So I think that we have to focus what we have right now, and what is the future about security with generative AI. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is David Victoria. I am probably Mexican. I'm probably Latino. So, and I love to speak. I love to share knowledge. I love to talk about cloud computing, about serverless, about security, and all the things. In love with my wife and beer. I can't compare. And obviously travel, because I am here. That's the reason because I'm here attending reInvent with all of us. So actually, I am cloud architect at Kaelent. Kaelent's a premier partner in the Amazon Partner Network. Recently, we won the Application Modernization Award in the global area. So I am AWS Community Builder and AWS User Group Leader. I am lecturer at Tech Monterey. I have 8 certifications, but it's just important who I am. The important thing right now, it's what I am. And I consider myself as a cloud advocate. So this is the first reason because I am talking about and trying to share a little of the experience of knowledge. This is going to be a very, dynamic session. Because as you know, English is not my first language. And maybe I will forget the words. And I will need help of all the people here. So this session focuses for builders. What is a builder? From my perspective, it's the people that are building the future, that are creating the new tech. This great definition says that a builder is a person with amazing or cool swag that creates or develops particular things, synonyms, wizard, creator, and mage. In this sort of ideas, I want to open your mind and think as a builder, not as an ML specialist or a DevSecOps engineer. Think as a builder, as a, people who are creating new technology. So when I start, when I create the abstract of this talk, it was June, July, August, I don't remember. But I was talking about Amazon Bedrock that in those moments was in private preview. I was talking about Jumpstart, foundational models. But the generative AI landscape is moving very fast. So today, we're going to mention some topics. We're going to talk about the actual status of security in AWS. Later, we're going to talk a little bit about Gen AI. All the people here know about Gen AI, right? Great. So later, we're going to talk a little bit about the challenges that we're facing on the security landscape, the new services that we will be implementing our workloads with Gen AI, and obviously, the new launches that we recently discovered here at reInvent. Historically, we have a suite of security tools or services that works very great in the AWS landscape. Detective, Code Guru, Inspector, DevOps Guru, WebDotty. All those services works in the backend with machine learning. Detective help us to analyze and visualize security data, investigate potential security issues. Code Guru detect, track, and fix code security vulnerabilities. With Inspector, we automate and continue analyzing vulnerabilities at the scale. With DevOps Guru, we implement application availability backend with ML technology. And WebDotty, my favorite, works to, in order to protect our AWS account with threat detection. So let's think or analyze this scenario. We have here a great architecture, a common architecture with API gateway, a web application firewall, some Lambda functions, etc. In this architecture, we implement some services like Code Guru, DevOps Guru. And imagine in this hypothetical scenario that we are under attack. Oops. We are under attack, and with WebDotty, we can detect and analyze the findings, for example, the brute force in the SSH protocol or with RDP protocol, et cetera. Guardori works amazing because Guardori gave us these findings as soon as possible, and we can start working in a event architecture, a security event architecture. For example, if Guardori detect, I don't know, SSH brute force, we can receive or gain visibility with some integrations with SNS, Simple Notification Service. This is a Slack receiving this message that says that we are under brute force attacks in some instance, or why not, we are under a port scan in our AWS infrastructure. And with this visibility, we can start thinking to implement event-oriented solutions or remediations. For example, in this case, we have a simple Lambda function that can remove a security group. Sorry, this Lambda, yes. close an open port in automatic fashion. Or in this other Lambda function, more complex, that actually isolate an instance, create an what's the name for a snapshot, and then notify to avoid the vector attack, the vector superficie, surface. Who was the winner? Thank you so much, Guille. As a builder, you want to know how it works internally. And I recommend a lot to you to review CodeGuru Detector Library, that in fact, it's the source that all those services use to analyze and find new vulnerabilities. About GenAI, I know that almost in LATAM, we saw this this same slide along all our meetups groups. So asking to Claude what is generative AI, Claude said that GenAI, it's a branch of artificial intelligence. We're not talking about new technology. We're talking about a technology that has more than 50 years. But we are right now working with the last part of the landscape. Generative AI, it's a branch of deep learning. Deep learning is a branch of machine learning. Machine learning is a branch of artificial intelligence. Right now, what challenges we are facing? Think about this. A cyber criminal, not hacker, because hacker is like a builder. A cyber criminal can take these large language models, foundational models, generative AI technology, and use to create malicious code, phishing emails, deepfake videos, fraudulent websites, etc. This cyber criminal can convert from an inexperienced person to a threat actor in a question of seconds. The good part, we can turbocharge our defense. For example, using generative AI to analyze my code for security review, to analyze the logs for detect anomalous patterns, to design customized cybersecurity courses inside our organization, to code a landing page, to find information in a document in our information security management system, etc. What we can do with this new landscape? We can start thinking to implement, like, use LLMs to create cyber threats, simulate cyber threats, or attack patterns in order to create internally new controls that can handle these new threats. Obviously, we can implement foundational models or generative AI in order to automate our security protocols. We can create strong prompts to ingest continuously our policies or patterns in order to gain visibility that are in compliance or no. We can simulate incident response scenarios. We can create realistic scenarios or tests or backups or disaster recovery plans. And about compliance, that is a topic that we work a lot at Kaylent. We can use two automatically generate or compliance reports or documentation. Who works in the DevSecOps area or create policies, documents, procedures? I know that feeling. So obviously we can with Gen AI gain time creating these policies or procedures easily. Obviously not delegating all the job to the foundational model or LLM, instead but change the LLM as a copilot for us. Another use cases can be the user behavior analysis. AI can analyze patterns, create and detect anomalies with the data. And of course, we can create more secure software. Who is using right now Code Whisperer? Who don't know about Code Whisperer? All the people know? Okay, great. Code Whisperer is a generative AI tool that helps us to create secure code or help us to code instead. At last, I think that we can create AI-driven risk assessments, analyzing what we have in our infrastructure. For example, right now with Amazon Q, we can ask, hey, give me a standard report about all my instances or infrastructure in general, and then compare with SOC 2 or ISO 27001. In AWS, who attended the keynote yesterday? A lot of people, great. So in the keynote, Adam said that we have right now three different layers. The layer that works with infrastructure, the second layer that offers services that builders can adopt, and the third layer, some services that are for final users. So in this case, I'm going to talk about the second layer, and I'm going to start with Amazon SageMaker Jumpstart. Amazon SageMaker, it's a tool that helps us to create all the pipeline in the machine learning environment. Starting with the cleaning the data, creating infrastructure, training models, and run the inference over those models. Jumpstart, that is a feature of SageMaker, have three different features. initially with computer vision models that are pre-trained computer vision models. The second is the natural language processing models. And the third, the most important from my perspective, that it's the foundational models. The foundational models are LLMs, large language models, but at AWS, we use this term to reference about a model that we can train over there and gain those, what's the name for? All the experience that the model have. In SageMaker Jumpstart, we have several different large language models available, from Stability AI, NC, AI 21 Labs, Hugging Face, Meta, Cohere, Alexa, LG AI Research, etc. In the other hand, we have Amazon Bedrock, that is a full serverless service, and in my perspective, the easiest way to build and scale generative AI applications. Bedrock offers us an easy way to interact in a serverless environment with machine with foundational models. We can build over a secure model. AWS take the model and create an instance for you inside your VPC, so you can trust on the data and trust all the encryption. And of course, Sage Bedrock deliver and a personalized experience because you can fine-tune your model, or right now, you can continuously training your model when you are using it. In Bedrock, we have the different foundational models. Obviously, Amazon Titan, that recently, today, Swami talked us about new models, foundational models inside Titan. We have Jurassic, Claude 2, now 2.1, and Command Embed, Stable Diffusion, and the last introduction, Llama 2. How do I know which service I need to implement? We can leverage SageMaker, or we can use Bedrock. But how I can take the decision to use one or another? There are several considerations. As an architect, I'm going to say it depends. So if you need to use a model that is not available in Bedrock, obviously, you will use SageMaker Jumpstart Foundational Models. If you need to customize a model that is not available in Bedrock, you have to use SageMaker Foundational Jumpstart. But if you need to accelerate your development, if you need to accelerate the way that you are securing your applications, for example, using code that you build with LangChain and use RAG to ingest your security documents and then analyze that, you can start using Bedrock as soon as possible. And about new launches, yesterday and today was amazing about the new services that we have available in the security landscape. Three of that, I want to talk about AWS Config with generative AI powered natural language querying, because now we can analyze our infrastructure with Config, that it's a service that helps us to assess and know what we have with a simple prompt. No, in this case, I am asking about which load balancers are created after January 1st, and I can have the complete query and then run inside Config and gain this visibility. Another service that recently new implement generative AI, it's CloudWatch. CloudWatch, I love CloudWatch. I prefer use CloudWatch instead than observability tool because I think have a lot of power. In this case, CloudWatch have logs insights. You can analyze all the information that you have ingested in your environment. And with a natural language, you can create prompts and create the queries to run inside CloudWatch, Amazon CloudWatch logs. In this case, I asked for show me the 10 quickest Lambda requests with error. And the GenAI tool helped me to wrote this amazing query. And at last, Amazon Q. Amazon Q, in my opinion, will be the disruptive tool in the GenAI landscape over AWS. Marketing says that Amazon Q will know about your all your infrastructure. You can ask about all the solutions that you have implemented, and obviously maintain the security, because Amazon Q will know about the roles and responsibilities of each one. So if I don't have permissions to analyze, I don't know, CloudWatch logs, Amazon Q will not answer anything about that. I think that, in my perspective, Amazon Q, in the next 3 or 6 months, will revolution the security landscape, not only gaining visibility, but powering another tools like CloudWatch logs or like Config or like QuickSight in order to create a full GenAI environment in AWS. So this is all for myself. I appreciate your time, and thank you so much.